gentlemen, this public hearing by the Committee on the Guam U.S. Military Relocation, Public Safety, and Judiciary is hereby called to order, convened on Tuesday, April 14th at 11 a.m. I will, first of all, like to thank my good colleagues, the Vice Chair of the Committee, Senator Tom Allen, to my immediate left, for joining us this morning. To my immediate right is Senator Mary Torres. Thank you, Senator, for joining us. And to her immediate right is Vice Speaker B.J. Cruz. On the agenda today, we do have the two legislative measures, Bill number 59, which is relative to personal relations and community property, and Bill number 65, relative to the participation of non-immigrant aliens admitted under the Compacts of Free Association in the Civilian Volunteer Police Reserve. So we will proceed with the first bill, Bill number 59-33, and if I can invite the following individuals, A. Lam, K. Chong, A. Rages, and T. Rojas. If you will be providing testimony, please, if I can invite you up to the front and present your comments and your testimony while we're waiting for you to join us. I would like to ask the sponsor of the legislation, Senator Mary Torres, to provide some opening comments. Senator Torres.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and I want to thank my colleagues for being here as well. Bill 59-33 is an act to amend subsection 6111B and to add new subsections 6111D, 6111E, and 6111F, all of Chapter 6, Title 19, Guam Code annotated, relative to personal relations and community property. Title 19, Guam Code annotated 6111 allows a husband and wife to contract with one another with respect to the support of each other and with respect to their property rights. The type of agreement between a husband and wife for support and maintenance determines whether it is subject to later modification by the courts. 19 GCA Section 8405, which is family support, is derived from California Civil Code Section 139. The California cases construing Section 139 hold that modification of support provisions in a divorce decree is available only when the support provisions are severable from the provisions dividing property. Our Guam courts recognize that there are three categories of settlement agreements between a husband and wife to provide for support and maintenance. The first category includes agreements in which the support provisions are in the nature of alimony and are separate from the provisions that divide property. The second category includes contracts in which the support provisions are not in the nature of alimony, but are part of the party's division of property, which includes also agreements that provide solely for the payment or periodic or lump sums in lieu of property. The third category includes a hybrid type of agreement, which contains both provisions for division of property and provisions for support. Now, the ability to modify an order for support depends on whether the provisions relating to the division of property and those relating to support are severable rather than integrated. If they are integrated, the order for support may not be modified unless the parties have provided for or agreed to such modification. As I mentioned earlier, Guam case law is based on old California case laws. The California statutes have been drastically amended such that in California, an agreement for spousal support is in general subject to subsequent modification or termination by court order, unless the parties specifically agree to the contrary. These statutory amendments have eliminated the need of the California trial court to examine each agreement to determine if it is integrated. My intention, Mr. Chairman, with Bill 5933 is to enact similar statutory revisions to modernize Guam laws so that the provisions or an agreement for support of either party shall be deemed to be separate and severable from the provisions of the agreement relating to property. And this will allow our courts to modify spousal support if substantial change in circumstances occur with the parties.
Thank you very much, Senator Torres. And as we proceed with receiving testimony of Bill number 59-33, just for the information of the public, I'm going to backtrack just a second. The initial notification of this particular public hearing was released on Monday, April 6th,
that legal issue that I find out that from my lawyer and from my understanding, the law in this case is very old. It's as old as me. It's 1939. I am just a baby that time, but the law is still using the same. So I say, why we are using this law so old? Oh, I said, well, that's the way we follow the rule. I say, well, how come you don't go to legislature and do something? Oh, certainly, I hear there's something that are coming from a senator that I just want to come here and say, maybe it's about time for our legislature to look forward. And maybe you guys, of course, you're all lawyer, and then maybe you can help us, you know? I'm not coming here to defend myself. This is not the case. We're talking about in the future. How about my children, my grandson? And they're going to end up the same thing like me. So I think it's good to come here and talk to you and ask your help, and maybe you guys can work on it. I know this kind of thing is not easy thing, but at least we'll get it started. So thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Lam, and I know that you have submitted written testimony also to the record. Please, if you can identify yourself for the record and proceed.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, Senator Elgin, Vice Chairman, Senator Atta, Senator Torres, and Senator Cruz. My name is Teresa Rojas. I'm an attorney with Berman, O'Connor, and Mann, and I'd like to provide oral testimony this morning on Bill 59.
Please proceed.
Thank you for providing our office with the opportunity to provide written and oral comment on Bill 5933. We believe that this bill serves the general need to modernize Guam's law on the issue of spousal support, be it for men or women. Importantly, this bill makes it clear that spousal support awards should always be modifiable, like child support, provided there is a material change in circumstances to either party, generally. At present, Guam courts rely on abstract and unbending legal principles drawn from a line of California cases decided decades ago, as Mr. Lam pointed out, which totally ignore the tidal wave of change regarding this area of law and the new economic, cultural, familial roles of men and women in a contemporary society. Numerous legislatures and courts in the recent past have sought to modernize their laws in this regard by permitting the modification of spousal awards. And where modification is permitted, the key facts for courts have been a finding of continued need by the receiving party and an ability to pay by the paying party. Again, where courts are given the authority to modify spousal support, they can only do so if there has been an unanticipated and substantial change in either spouse's circumstances, such as job loss, illness, retirement, or marriage. Today, there are parties on Guam who have no substantial need for continued alimony or spousal support due to their changed circumstance following years of divorce, such as an increase to wealth and assets or remarriage. On the other end, payers or obligors of alimony have also experienced change by going into retirement, be it voluntarily or involuntarily, or having been faced with unanticipated illness altering their capacity to work. The problem with Guam's present statute is that it places a burden on our trial courts to examine each agreement entered in a proceeding of divorce to determine whether an award or agreement for spousal support can be modified. And without any change to legislation, our trial courts use specific factors to determine if this modification is permissible. Most importantly, their searches for integration of spousal and property award divisions. Here, Senator Torres, in introducing the amendment to Chapter 6, Title 19, makes it law that in an agreement for property settlement, it is always separate from alimony, that in an agreement for property settlement, property is always separate from alimony and spousal support. And spousal support can always be modified unless the marital agreement says that it cannot be, still permitting the parties to retain their autonomy to allow them to enter into an agreement to create lifelong, unmodifiable, permanent alimony if they permit. Even our Supreme Court has recognized the need for change to Guam's law in this regard, but they have determined that this change is best left to our policy discussing Guam's present analysis of the court's ability to modify spousal support can be reviewed under Supreme Court Opinion 2015 Guam 6, a very recent opinion. In closing, we applaud and commend Senator Torres as the bill's author for introducing this measure, as this amendment is a modern approach to a complex area of law in dire need of reform. Thank you, Senator Chairman Aguon, Vice Chairman Ada, Senator Torres, and Senator Cruz, for allowing the firm to express our support, and sincerely we urge the committee's full support on this bill.
Thank you very much, Ms. Ross, and thank you also for participating in this process and at least encouraging an update of our existing statutes. Senator Torres, any questions? Or?
I just want to thank you very much for providing that. Oftentimes we take for granted these old laws, and in today's present society where divorce is a great percentage of marriages that end in divorce, you know, we have to think about the well-being of all subjects to move on with their lives in the best way possible. And in circumstances where there are changes and substantial changes in circumstances that warrant modification, we have to be cognizant of that and allow our courts the purview and the ability to determine what the needs, true needs are, and the modification levels. So I thank you very much for providing very relevant testimony, Mr. Lamb, in the form of you know, a personal point of view, which I think is very valid and important for us to consider in policy decisions. And Attorney Rojas, also, I appreciate your professional input into this matter. Since it was Masi.
Thank you very much, Senator.
Thank you.
Senator Ada, or any questions? If not, thank you again for your testimony this morning. We will proceed to bill number 65-33, relative to the participation of non-immigrant